Hi guys, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minute Fixes, the series where I demonstrate very quickly how small DIY repairs can be done. Today, I'm going to show you a quick overview of how I repair deeply scratched or gouged bumpers. Guys, before we start, I know this should go without saying, but there have been a few comments on other videos about repairs taking longer than 5 minutes to complete. So to be clear, these videos are designed to give you an overview of how a repair works, without any unnecessary junk in between, all in less than 5 minutes. Naturally, any paint or bodywork based repair is going to take time, as materials need to dry. So, with that cleared up, let's get into it. First up, I start by wet flatting the affected area with 1200 grit sandpaper, before cleaning with panel wipe. This gives me a good clean base to work from. With that done, it's time to fill the low areas caused by the damage. For this, I use standard off-the-shelf 2K automotive body filler. Once that filler has fully dried, I sand it down. First with a light dry sanding stage to denib it, then I move on to wet sanding. In this case, I use graduating stages of wet and dry, starting at 800 grit and ending up at 1200 grit. Although you can still see where the damage was, the area is now completely smooth to the touch. Once the area has been thoroughly cleaned and dried to remove any moisture or filler residue, it's time to mask up. You'll notice here that I masked to all panel edges and to the shoulder line of the lower bumper, as this is the easiest place for me to blend the new paint into the old. At this stage, we're almost ready to go, but just to be safe, I like to give the area one more key across the larger area and a final clean. I'm being careful not to get the area too wet and disturb the masking. For this repair, I'm using a store-bought aerosol in the correct manufacturer colour. As I'm not working in a spray booth, these aren't optimal conditions for painting, and as aerosol can go on quite thin, I like to play it safe and lay down several light coats while simultaneously warming the area with a heat gun. I use a technique of fading the new paint across the whole keyed area. This gives me the opportunity to gradually and smoothly blend the new paint into the existing paint. As always, I'll include links in the video description to some of the products and tools that I use. When the new paint is fully dry, it's time to apply the new clear coat. Again, in this example, I'm using a standard store-bought aerosol clear coat 1K automotive lacquer. The first job is to make sure the panel is properly clean and free from any contaminants by giving it a wipe down with panel wipe degreaser. Next, the application of the clear coat isn't too dissimilar to that of the paint. I start by laying down several light dusty coats across the whole area, while simultaneously warming the area with a heat gun before moving on to a few heavier, wet coats towards the end, being sure to keep the panel gently warm throughout the process. When the clear coat has thoroughly cured and hardened, it's time to wet flat it, ready for final polishing. I start by wet sanding the new clear coat with a high grade sandpaper. In this case, I'm using 1200 grit. The next stage is to remove the masking from the surrounding paint and lightly wet flat those areas too. This will help to blend the overall repair into the car without making one section look brand new whilst being surrounded by tired paint. Any dullness caused by this process will be removed by the machine polishing stage. The final stage is to polish up the newly flatted and now dull clear coat. I do this by using a machine polisher, but if you don't have one of these, it is possible to do by hand, it just takes a lot longer. I'm using some cutting compound on a medium firm foam pad. This gives me plenty of control over the amount of cut being applied to the area. After a few passes with the polisher and a buff off with a microfibre cloth, the newly repaired area is revealed. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. My goal here is to try and show that you are able to tackle repair jobs such as this yourself without always being at the mercy of a garage. I'm not saying I'm the best body guy in the world, just a small trader who's had to learn to do things in-house to save costs. Hopefully you'll agree that the results speak for themselves. If you've enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, please consider subscribing.